Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for inviting me to open Kyberschach's Cyber Chess 2019. What I would like to do over the next few minutes is to put some of the issues which you will be examining into a broader security context, with an emphasis on your role within it. There are a number of ways in which humanity has developed which now threaten our very existence. Three are particularly dangerous. Last week, we heard a lot about the dramatic consequences of climate change. Whether or not we will find out from this threat, it's a question. The continued proliferation of nuclear weapons means that the Cold War era of mutually assured destruction, or MID, as it was correctly called, is not simply a matter of history. When authoritarian or unstable countries possess these weapons, then the chances of them getting into the hands of terrorists are imaginable. When nuclear limitations treaties are being abandoned and so-called nuclear de-escalation is actually played out in war games, we are in a dangerous situation. Biological risks are also underestimated. The probably continued development of biological weapons provides the possibility of accidents with devastating consequences. To this, we must add the dangers of the anti-vaccination movement and the rapid decline of effectiveness of antibiotics. Let us remember that the Spanish flu 1918 to 1920 killed between 3% and 5% of the world population. It's a lot, much more than the persons who were killed in the First World War. You may wonder why I'm talking about such risks on your conference. Well, the extraordinary rapid development of ICT technology is increasingly affecting our all lives, including these external risks. Climate change can only be controlled by the whole world if the whole world participates, a matter of communication. The accidental release of nuclear weapons can happen through faulty software or the incorrect interpretation of incoming signals. Controlling health issues is again a matter of communication. In other words, they are closely linked to the essence of your conference. The basics of technological security remain unchanged while the complexity of the tasks continues to increase. We still need to protect our networks, ensure continuity of the service and data integrity. Traditional cyber threats continue to target our communications, our provisions of such essentials as financial sectors, electricity, and water supplies. But now the combination of cyber threats and strategic communications to take into account a period of cognitive war where our resilience will be further tested. Fake news or information warfare deal with facts or their distortion. Cognitive war, on the other hand, aims deeper. That is our interpretation and perception of these facts. Large-scale information manipulation is a kind of hacking of our hearts and minds. It is ironic that even your own technologies are becoming victims. when the Twitter account of the CEO of Twitter is hacked and mishandled, or the opportunities provided by the 5G technology are delayed by social media wisdom, then it is clear that we have to be more vigilant. The quality of our information space plays a key role in defining our quality of life. Technological advancement is meant to bring to us prosperity, make our lives easier. But the data harvesting and the big data is also a source for the monitoring of all individuals and also the source of manipulation of all individuals. We have already seen how populist movements can quickly become more attractive in this new environment. When we add to this the growth of the filter bubbles, encryption of social media and its fragmentation into like-minded groups, then it is unsurprising that what has been called the continued influence effect on perception has huge potential. Security is an integral part of our economic well-being, our social and political structures. Therefore, if reliable and safe information and communications are matters of national security, the question arises about the role of the state. For a fragile democracy or an authoritarian regime, developing technologies can pose a serious threat. For this same, technologies can equally provide also a means for the state control of its population. We see this already in some countries which are ruled by authoritarian regimes. We must not fall into a trap of overregulation, censorship, and the misuse of the rule of law. The techniques such as facial recognition and other similar techniques provides us with a tool for social engineering. And if these tools falls in the false hands, I would say, then of course the democracy and the rule of law is in danger. Ladies and gentlemen, we return to my central theme of democracy and the protection of our common values. The digital resilience of our democratic systems is in your hands and in the hands of your many colleagues around the world. We know how hybrid threats can be developed in cyberspace. The growth of artificial intelligence and machine learning will soon affect warfighting. Are we prepared to envisage machines making decisions about the life or death of human beings? Perhaps not in our societies, but these technologies are available also to authoritarian regimes and even terrorist substates. Democracy can only prosper in open, well-educated and informed societies. The habit of critical thinking is as important as the access to information. This is not of importance to politicians alone. It is essential for the basic freedoms and values we take for granted in our daily lives. While technological development may not threaten our existence in the way I described at the beginning of my talk, it has an all-pervasive and increasing influence on us all. As states, as democratic states, we have the responsibility to educate users and to teach our children critical thinking. We have to tackle private issues in a fair and even-handed manner, even though that itself it's a huge challenge. Of you, their professionals, we ask to you take into account the consequences of where of your heading, of what you are doing. The decisions you make, the products and services you create and run to be considered in the wider security context. In the era of a cognitive war, reputational security, I repeat, reputational security is as important for business as it is for politicians. We must all make sure that we do not put our societies and states under threats through the consequences or unintended actions which we have not meant. The technologies we dream about, we build, and we all use have not only to be safe and secure, but also responsible. Responsible consequences. I think this is a word which this conference should take in consideration. I hope you will give us the possibility to a lot of discussion about also this links between security and our common values and the topic of the conference of the Cyber Chess 2019. Thank you very much.